Jan Aldrich Clanton, May 3rd, 1946, Abilene, Texas.
How does bringing the feminine sacred names into worship encourage the revaluing of the feminine perception?
Well, our sacred symbols reflect and shape our deepest values, and if all of our sacred symbols are masculine, then that is giving value to men and boys and excluding girls and women. And so my mission has been to include feminine divine names and images and mine the scriptures, the Hebrew scriptures and Christian scriptures, for a wealth of feminine divine images and bring them into ritual, into churches. As Mary Daly said way back in 1973 in Beyond God the Father, if God is male, then male is God. And my mission has come partly from my background as a language teacher. I'm an English teacher, and I realized pretty early on in the feminist movement how important it was to have inclusive language for humanity. And then when I was ordained one of the first Baptist ministers in Texas and experienced a lot of discrimination and criticism and all that, it dawned on me that the foundational problem here was our image of the divine. And if we continue worshiping only male deity, then not only is it a problem for women in the church, they're second class, but in society too. Because if we're going to truly believe that we're in the image of the divine, then we need to have divine feminine images.
Why do you feel these events centered on women are so important?
Well, I think these events are crucial to the revaluing of the feminine, because unfortunately in our country and throughout the world, women are still devalued. And so to bring women together and help them to feel that we are truly in the image of the divine, and to help the self-esteem of women. Now, these conferences also include men who are open and advocating for women and the self-esteem of women. But these events, I think, are crucial. And I've realized through this how many women have been empowered through believing that they are in the image of the divine. And so one of the things that I speak on is expanding our images of the divine to include the feminine. And it's all about empowering women and girls to be all we can be in the divine image.
Great. And finally, what advice do you have for young women starting to build their career today?
I would say, go for whatever you are led to as far as your gifts. Get all the education you can. Believe in yourself. Believe that you are created in the divine image and that you have power and that you are equal. And I think if that comes internally, that you are equal, there are going to be obstacles, and there are still obstacles, unfortunately, but that you can believe in yourself and then connect with other women and be empowered and inspired by other women. For instance, I have been by women in ministry like Martha Gilmore. I had my epiphany at her ordination at Cliff Temple Baptist Church by Ann Richards in politics. I told her she was a marvelous preacher, and she laughed at that, but she really was a wonderful role model of a powerful woman preacher. So I think connecting with other women, seeing role models, and then just claiming your gifts, your God-given gifts.